When we look at the issue of global warming, it's so important to look at our communication. I think the way this problem has been framed for so many of us, our only options are to either change our light bulbs or drive less or eat less meat or something, or contact our federal legislators. And so there's this whole world that's missing at the community level for engagement.
We realize that a lot of elected officials that we talked to had a yearning to be a part of something like this, but that there wasn't the framework for it together.
We thought it was really important to have leaders come together around this issue, but instead of just talking about the doom and gloom, we wanted to provide leaders with tools that were already in action around the globe that we can do right here.
So today is really about generating collective action here locally in the Kansas City area based upon the work of Drawdown that reminds us that we actually do know what to do to reverse global warming. We have the means already in place to make it happen. Our job now is to increase implementation of the things that we know to do and scale them up to a level that's needed to actually achieve the goal of reversal.
I was completely overwhelmed today by the large number of people from across the entire metropolitan area of Kansas City that all came together on a Saturday morning to talk about what I think is the most existential challenge that we face right now, which is addressing climate change, and doing so at the local government where we can make real progress.
And it's not advocates who put this on, it's actually elected officials, and that's very powerful and a very hopeful sign, probably the most hopeful sign I've seen in the last 5 or 6 years.
I think a lot of the conversation around climate change tends to be kind of catastrophic, and they touched on that a couple of times, but this one was really a positive approach to getting people to change their behaviors about it, so I think that's really effective.
What stood out to me today is that all the solutions are there to solve climate change, it's just a matter of political will.
Many of the solutions are already in progress, and it's not a challenge of starting them, it's a challenge of scaling them up so they have greater impact.
We talked a lot about food waste and food waste solutions, which is something that I've been concentrating on.
Who would have guessed that something as simple as changing the way we eat could have such a huge impact on global warming?
The things that we hear in the news have kind of superseded quiet work that's happening. It's really cool to be in the same room with other people who are very engaged and hopeful.
It feels like the energy's there and the opportunity is there to really scale up and try and do something big.
The biggest takeaway I have is that there really are things that we can do at the local level to make a difference, both economically and improving the greenhouse gas emissions.
We're talking about partnerships. We're talking about identifying ways that we can move forward together. And so this is an exciting time.
We had 135 people participating. We had leaders from all levels of government, both sides of the state line, with so many really impressive organizations here as well. So that number of people together around this issue is what makes it so powerful.
There is leadership here on this issue for the area, and it was just looking for a group to run with it. And I'm glad we've identified this group, and I'm just really excited for what it's going to bring.